Our thinking creates our reality. The size of our thinking decides the amount of greatness that we create in reality. What one person has achieved can be achieved by anyone. What is possible for one to do on this earth is possible for everyone, as every one of us is born with equal potentials. But the attitude of discrimination that others are great, others are lucky, others are destined makes us inferior. Inferior feeling only develops hatred towards ourselves, and that hatred creates selfishness. In inferiority, we never become a performer, but indeed a blamer of everything, which also develops selfishness. When we love ourselves, we love everything on this earth. But when we hate ourselves, think what happens? We hate everything. Selfishness in thinking can never bring out the true potential within us, as we never think great. What is life? Not realizing our potentials? So never discriminate. Even if the whole world rejects us, we should never reject ourselves. We are all of equal potential. Whatever may be our status, whether we are rich or poor, smart or ugly, intelligent or dull, upper caste or lower caste, we should never discriminate ourselves, as we cannot destroy ourselves. To illustrate this, let me take you through the life of John H. Johnson, who never discriminated himself, though he lived during the times wherein the society was dominated by discrimination, and rose from a very humble position to first African American to appear on the Forbes 400. Though John's early life was filled in poverty with the death of his father, his mother's encouragement made him to attend school during the time wherein there was no public high school for black students. He was the president of his class and always stood first, and his interest towards journalism made him the editor of the school's newspaper. Later, with some experience in news publishing, he created his first venture, Johnson Publishing Company. His skin color made it tough for him to get a loan of $500, but using his mother's furniture as collateral, he could get that loan. The first book was printed in the name Negro Digest in November 1942. 3 years later, he launched Ebony for African Americans, which sold over 50,000 copies, making him nation's widely circulated publisher. Later in 1951, he launched Jut, a news weekly magazine. Getting married, he adopted 2 children. In 1973, launched Fashion Fair Cosmetics. Later, got into other forms of media, operating multiple radio stations. By 1980, he became country's richest business leader. He boldly published the racial injustice during those days. He made Martin Luther King Jr. to write an advice column for Ebony. He received many awards and accolades for his contributions, and he was also awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by Bill Clinton, crediting him as African Americans, a voice and a face, which means a new sense of somebody-ness, of who they were and what they could do. His attitude of not rejecting himself introduced his entire race to beauty and the brilliance they already had. Realize oneness. Realize equality. Realize that everyone is equally potential. Never discriminate. Every day, in every way, life is getting better and better. Don't miss to be a part of Venuskill Training Academy, as you can't miss life.